boys. Hey, girl. JB here. Welcome to JB's Louisiana Cajun Cooking Recipes channel. How you call it, channel? 007 Bond JB. Now, you know. Miss JB out of town. Boy, I can have fun, drink pops, do whatever in the hell I want to do. Run around the house with scissors, it don't matter. All they got is the dog, and my son brought his dog over here too. So I got two chihuahuas, and we're going to go grill us a steak. Let me turn on the studio lights. Hold up. Got a happy birthday to Aline Rheingold. It's going to be 65 on June the 15th. Happy birthday, girl. So I got a nice little porterhouse right here. And we're going to put some Maldon sea salt on it. If you don't got this, just use kosher salt. We're going to apply it on both sides. And then go put this in the refrigerator. Go put some black salt on it. Yeah. That's the word. That's black pepper. Fresh crack, too, by the way. Flip this over with that hand and use the clean hand to apply some more salt. And what is a porterhouse? A porterhouse, this is the filet mignon, and this is the New York strip. So put some pep on that side and go put this sumbitch in the refrigerator and let it sit in there for at least an hour. You could let it sit overnight, matter of fact. And it'll be even better, but I'm hungry. I'll be hungry after I've drank a few more pops. And I got a little bacon potato right here. That's how big it is. That's a male size hand. See right there? Look, 12 ounce beer. See him taller than that. So he must be a tall boy potato. Gonna bake that off. And I got avocado pear. Yeah, one of them things. And if I remember, I'll make that too because that's health fruit. Yeah, I just like it. It's good for you. And it's good for my belly. Because it got a lot of fat in it. So let me go put that steak in the fridge. And my oven's preheating. Then we go outside and play with fire, because that's what drunk Cajun retired plumbers do. Oh boy. Now Miss JB said I had to put up the dishes. And so I'm working at that. Are you recording, stupid? Good. So the oven's ready. I'm going to go ahead and put that baked potato in there. But first I gotta put up the silverware. And Miss JB got the silverware drawer all organized with the forks and the knives and everything where they go. And I take too much damn time. And she hates it when I do that. Now, it's all in the drawer. Just grab what you need. She ain't here though. She went out of town. Let me put the potato in the oven. And then we can go watch Sanford and Son or whatever the hell we want to do. Go find the scissors. You know, steak's out the oven or out the fridge and been resting at room temperature for about 20 minutes. It'd been in the fridge for an hour. And we're going to go put it out there on the grill and give it a little bit of smoke. with some hickory and apple wood that I have out there. Just a combo. Now I've been keeping my grill below 300. And there's a piece of wood in there that's trying to flare up and be non-union. We're gonna put it out. And that's a big old T-bone. You can see that hickory and apple wood down in there. So we're gonna light a fire. Come on, light, bitch. Plumber's torch. Start searing this steak. I got a bigger tip for this torch, but I don't feel like I'm gonna dig it out. This would be better because I can control the temperature. Burn that fat off. Now let's give it a little flip and see what it looks like. Looks just fine. Crisp up the fat. It'll be like bacon. Let's go let this rest now. Pull him off the grill. You happy? Yeah. Pull him off the grill and let it rest for about 10 minutes. So tint your steak. Put a lid on it. Let it rest. About 10 minutes. That same plate we're going to put the baked tater in. Not shown on video, I opened up this Dawn Fresh mushroom steak sauce, added some garlic powder to it, about a teaspoon, and we're warming it up. I also brushed down some leftover hamburger buns that we're going to put on the stove and cook them. Look over here, not camera boy. I got an avocado, a lime. Let's make us some simple sliced avocado to go along with our steak. Okay, so get the little seed out of there and kind of dice your avocado up like that. Not dice it, just slice it. Slice and dice. Pour it off and eat the yumness. If it don't escape. Yum. Do the other part. So you got some little slices. You can put this on your potato, you can put it in your mouth. Yum. I'm dining by myself, so I can do what the hell I want to do. Lick my fingers. But you do gotta put some lime juice on this to keep it from turning brown. You paying attention? Okay. Toss this about. Got you a little avocado. Yum. And it's a healthy fruit. And yes, avocado is a fruit. If you didn't know. Okay. Yum. Now you could do this on your gas outside. Put you some bread on there. Turn the fire down low. And give it a go, Joe. And let... I buttered the bread first. See? We'll give it a little bit of warm up, crisp up, butter yumness for dipping. And the yumness. Just, if I had too much to drink, no, I'm standing up. I'm going to get another pop right now. Now that our steak is rested, let's take the resting plate, put it over here, and drink a pop. And put our baked potato right on top. Watch this, kitties. Sit down there. Listen. Hot. Crackly, crispy baked potato. You got some bad parts, dig them out. Getting a little bit of butter for our tater. And putting the butter in the crispy tater. Yumness. No salt. No bullshit. Some pepper. Some sour cream. You could also put cream cheese in here, but I happen to have something equally as good. And this is queso fresca. It's a Mexican crumbling cheese. And we're gonna apply that. Because I got it. And it is delicious. Okay. Now, you can dump. Watch this. Stupid camera. I took some of the mushroom sauce, the garlic mushroom sauce that I made, and pour it on top of the baked potato. There's some avocados with lime. Jump in my mouth. Here's our steak. I gotta go get me something to cut it with. Stand by. She got a toy, and I got a sister, I mean her daughter over here, little Lila. Come here. Hey, girl. She kind of chubby. I want to mention that steak, not the steak, the baked potato. I used just a conventional oven right there, the regular old oven. I set it at 350. But it's off about 15 degrees, so it really cooked at about 365-ish. And I didn't really time it. It was about an hour and a half, maybe an hour and 45 minutes to get it that crispy. It wasn't wrapped in foil. I washed it, put it on the middle rack, set it, and let it eat. And that's how it come out. That's how they always come out. You don't gotta rub them with oil. You don't gotta rub them with bacon fat. Put bacon inside the tater. That'd be better.